Hi guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. For today's video, we are going to be heading to Ulta. Why, you may ask? Why? I don't want to go to Ulta today. Let me tell you. So you guys know about once a month, I love going to Ulta to see what new makeup they have. Recently, a bunch of new things released, like the ABH Jackie Aina palette, the Benefit Creaseless Concealer, the Urban Decay Naked Skin Foundation, a bunch of products from Makeup Revolution, and then a bunch of other products from the drugstore, right? So I love going to the actual store to see like the displays, all the color options they have to offer. I love playing with swatches, all of that. So yeah, today that's what we're gonna do. I wanna take you guys along with me. You loved how I took you guys along with me on the train in my Sephora video. So I made sure to film some of that as well. Just so you kind of get a glimpse of New York if you're not from New York. I will go ahead and have my previous Shop With Me Ulta video down below in the description box so you guys can see like what it's about if you're new to these kind of videos, or if not, then you pretty much know. Take you there, play, then we come back. This time around though, I did not purchase anything just because I do want to place an order on Ulta's site, shop through Ebates, all of that, get cash back because why not, but then also because I want to just place a big order and just do like a big daddy like Ulta haul as opposed to picking up one thing here, one thing there, you know. Anyways, let's go ahead and get started. Forever and ever and ever. Definitely need the GPS once again to Ulta Beauty. We have a 4-minute walk.
Ulta is literally a whole entire block. How bomb is that? This one right here is on 3rd Avenue and 86th Street.
So the first display I see here is from the Pure and Barbie collection. This is so, so cute. I'm so happy that they collaborated with Barbie. Barbie came out in the 60s, you guys told me. I thought it came out like in the 80s or 90s. But basically here's what the collection looks like. There's an eyeshadow palette, a highlighter slash blush, 4 lipsticks, and a gloss, which is not there. Here's what the packaging looks like. It's so beautiful. It has like this gorgeous textured feel. There's like little stones on it. I love playing with Barbie. It was like my favorite thing ever. And then here's what the palette looks like on the inside. We get 12 different shades and so many different finishes. Here's a first row swatch. They swatched pretty nicely. Not, oh my goodness, but not bad. These were with 2 swipe swatches each. Here's a second row swatch. We get some beautiful pinks and then that really pretty satiny semi-metallic blue. And then here's how the final row swatches. The shade closest to my wrist is like a loose glitter, like it has a very textured feel. And then the other shades are just pretty smooth. That black one there is just a true black with like pink and purple glitters. We also have the Dream Glow Signature Highlighter Palette, which looks just like this. Same packaging as the palette. Open it up, and then here's what it looks like. So depending on your skin tone, you'd be able to use it as a highlighter or as a blush topper. So here you guys can see how the highlighter swatches. That biggest swatch is when all of the shades are swatched together, and then the 3 on bottom are the 3 shades swatched individually. So basically, this highlighter has 3 different shades. I don't know if you guys can tell from here, but there was one shade here, here, and here. And then here are the 4 lipsticks that are included in the collection. They're the Signature Semi Matte Lipsticks, $18 each. And you guys can see from the poster what the shades will look like. Most of these are kind of done in a way where like they're like broken or like really like touched to death, so I'll still try to get a swatch. Here's what the lipstick looks like up close. It has a textured glittery feel, but the glitter does not come off, and the glitter goes from like this beautiful pink to like this silver. Also, the way you like kind of open it up is you push this piece down and then the lipstick pops out from under there and you just pull it out. I also love the fact that it says Pure X Barbie all over the bullet. I just think it just adds a nice touch to it. Starting from that purpley grape type of shade, that's called Inspire. On bottom of that we have Legendary, which is a true pink. Then we have Timeless, and then Classic. Classic is probably my favorite, and then Timeless is a close second. The next display I see here is from NARS. Look at that, isn't that so cool? Looks trippy, love it. The guy here is like staring me down. So anyway, we have an eyeshadow palette that includes 8 different eyeshadows as well as some blushes and bronzers. That's retailing for $49 and it's exclusive to Ulta. And then this is pretty cool. We have these NARS lipstick duos. So we have the warm duo and the cool duo. And these duos are retailing for $20 each. So 2 lipsticks for $20 and the deluxe sizes. Here's what the packaging of the lipsticks look like. Really cool. I love it. Just slides out of the sleeve here. Then you have the lip products inside. So here are the 2 that are from the warm kit. This one right here is called Band Red. It's a satin. This one right here is Tonka, T-O-N-K-A, and that one is a matte. Here you guys can see how they swatch. The top one is Tonka. I don't know what the name that is. But anyway, it's like a mid-tone, pretty deep nude. And then the bottom one is Band Red. These are the two that are part of the cool kit. So we have Catfight and Love and Lips, and they're both mattes. Apparently that's what it states. So here you guys can see the top one is Catfight. It's like a matte, but it has little glitters in there. And then the bottom one is Love and Lips. It's a beautiful mauve-y color. Here's the palette. Firstly, here's what the box looks like. Really cute. Again, this is just a sleeve. The actual palette doesn't have any picture on it. It just says NARS. Very simple, very sleek. So pretty much a one-stop shop type of palette. You can use this for the eyes and face. Here's how the four face powders swatch. Definitely very light. These are with like 2 to 3 swatches each. You probably will have to build them up. We get Laguna as well as Orgasm Blush in here. And then the other two shades are Dolce Vita and Luster. Here's how the four top shades swatch. We get two glittery shades, one satin and one matte on the bottom there. And then here we have the four remaining eyeshadows swatched. These were a bit more pigmented and more vibrant. The next section we have here is from Urban Decay, and this is the Stay Naked foundation line. Here you guys can see that there are a nice amount of shades to choose from. Urban Decay did go ahead and send over two of these Stay Naked foundations in two different shades. Here's what the packaging looks like. It's really pretty. It has a gold lid and it has a pump to it too. So I have been testing out this foundation. I would say it has medium-ish coverage, like light to medium, and it's not, oh my goodness, buildable, but it's buildable to an extent. I like that it's really light on the skin. It just feels very like effortless and just perfect for every day. This foundation's retailing for $39. It says 50 shades up to 24-hour wear, real skin, matte finish, vegan. Next up, I see the ABH and Jackie Aina collaboration. This is so cool. You guys asked me if I'm gonna be picking this up. I actually wanted to check it out in store to see if it's something that I would enjoy, so here we are. I love the packaging though, it's really cool. Here's what the packaging looks like. Beautiful. It's retailing for $45, just like the other ABH palettes. And then here are the shades that are included. Sponsored, Edges, Trust Issues, Ginger. Very pretty. Okay, so here's the first row swatched. These are beyond deliciously soft. They were with one swipe swatches each. Besides for that purple one in the middle, I swatched that one twice. But everything else seemed to be very pigmented, very creamy, no skipping, not a lot of kick up. Just like her other palette, just as I assumed and presumed. So very, very nice. And then here we have the second row swatched. A nice amount of oranges, a purple, some mattes, some glitters. That shade on top is really cool. It's like a green, but it kind of like looks brown at the same time, depending on how you move. These are with two swipe swatches each, and they're like, well, I'm very impressed. Didn't think I would be like blown away, but I got it. Also, ABH recently released this liquid liner, retailing for $18. It says, highly pigmented, true black, matte liquid liner with a felt tip precision applicator. Guys, no, I suck with these, so it doesn't really like speak to me, but we're still gonna swatch it and see if it bleeds. I feel like I should just learn how to use these, because it looks so pigmented and smooth and black, and I feel like it would look so bomb on the eyes, you know, and it's not bleeding. Whoa! Okay, then we have this massive display of the ABH Luminous Foundations. This literally took a hold of the whole entire internet. You guys know how many shades are included. I want to say about 40 shades in the line. We have shades from fair to light to tan to deep. These are $38. So here are a few important things it says about it. It says suitable for sensitive skin, long-wing, no flashback. Also, if you guys can see, it says it's a medium coverage foundation with a luminous natural finish. Yes. So here's what the packaging looks like. I like that it says foundation. It's like, what? But I like it. I don't know. And then on this side, it says Anastasia Beverly Hills Luminous Foundation. There's a pump to it, which I love because it makes things a billion times easier. I always say that. Yes, you can see my hairs. But it swatches pretty nicely. It doesn't have a majorly thick feel to it. And I can kind of see like the luminous finish it's kind of talking about, you know? I mean, obviously I can only tell once it's on my face, but I like the consistency, it's nice. Then we have this display of loose powders from ABH. I didn't even know that these released. They're retailing for $36 each. There's 0.9 ounces of product in each as well. Like, these are freaking huge. I love the packaging. It's kind of giving me like MAC vibes, but it's ABH. Yeah, it looks really cool. We have them in 5 different shades. So we have translucent, which is pretty much stark white. This one right here is in vanilla, a little bit more, it's kind of like an off-white color. Then we have banana, very classic shade. I'd probably get either vanilla or banana. We then have deep peach if you have a tan skin tone. And then we have golden orange if you have a deeper complexion. Then we're at the Makeup Revolution section. I'm kind of impressed by this brand because I feel like they constantly release products that are just so affordable. You know, kind of like ColourPop in a way, but not as popular, I should say. Anyways, here we have the Makeup Revolution and Rachel Leary collection. I don't know where the tester is, unfortunately, so I cannot swatch anything. Damn. But the palettes look great. So we have the Goddess On The Go palette, which is pretty much warmer in tone. We get some face powders in here, as well as eyeshadows. This is retailing for 15 bucks. Here's what the palette looks like. We have a few of these here. But when you turn it around, you can't really see what the colors look like, which is okay. And then we have this Rachel Leary palette here, which is retailing for 20 bucks. It seems like it's a bit larger. There are more face powders in here, and then more eyeshadows. And for this one, they're all gone. Then we have this palette here, the Makeup Revolution X Tammy palette. It has a bunch of colorful shades, really, really pretty. The outer packaging seemed like it would have been like, you know, what's it called? Like rave style, you know? 15 bucks, and this is also all gone. Bending down, we have some of the Makeup Revolution Conceal and Define concealers. These are 7 bucks each. I thought that this was nice. I wasn't crazy over it. I don't know what the story was. But they recently went ahead and released the Conceal and Define foundation, 12 bucks. And I hear it's supposed to be hydrating. A few of you guys actually tagged me on this, like on a post of these on Instagram. And I was like, thanks, I didn't even know. So here's what the foundation looks like. It's pretty much the same exact packaging as the concealer, but in a big daddy size. I'm assuming it's gonna also have that like doe foot applicator, which I like when they do that with foundations. I feel like it's not as sanitary, but I don't know, it's still kind of fun. We have another Makeup Revolution section here. I spoke about these donuts a few months ago in a different Ulta video. These are so cute, they smell amazing. And yeah, I just need to remember to buy them. Like maybe when I place an order online. Then we have this section as well. We've gone through those palettes, but we've never seen these. And you guys know how addicted I am to mists of any kind, of all kinds. I don't discriminate. These are 8 bucks. We have green tea, guava rose, vanilla and coconut, which is apparently gone, and then peaches and cream. And then we have some of these little baby palettes here as well. So some of these are eyeshadow palettes and some of these are face palettes. So all of these little babies are 7 bucks. Sometimes we find these little babies at TJ Maxx, but not too often. A few of you guys actually mentioned that this is a dupe for the Charlotte Tilbury Filmstar bronzer and highlighter. So I might want to do like a comparison video between both because this is $7 and Charlotte Tilbury one is 68. Okay, this looks delicious. This looks like something I would be dying over. Like, look at this shade. Yum. And then the packaging is so cute. I need to collect the Too Faced palettes. I need to collect these. And then we also have these Makeup Revolution chocolate lip glosses, 5 bucks each. The lids are in this beautiful rose gold type of color. And I really like the shades. I feel like they're going to be perfect for a day-to-day like basis. So beautiful, so beautiful. I want all of them. And I want to also show you guys that Benefit recently released their new Boing concealers, which just looks so cute. I actually purchased this from Sephora already. Not bad. I'm still playing around with it. We have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 different shades to choose from, 23 bucks each. But I love the fact that they also have it in a deluxe size, which is retailing for 13 bucks. They don't have the deluxe sizes in every single color, which is unfortunate. I feel like they should have. But then I feel like they wouldn't make money that way, you know? Anyway, you can purchase the deluxe size if you find your shade to see if you like it. And then you can always purchase the full size once you finish the deluxe size if you don't want to spend 23 bucks just like that. We have a new Maybelline display out. This is the Superstay Under Eye Concealer, retailing for $11.99 each. There are 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 shades to choose from. This is brand new to the game. It's just literally, like I said, it just released. It says complete coverage, waterproof, transfer resistant. I used to like the foundation that was part of the line, but then I'm like, oh, a little bit too thick for me. So yeah, I'm not sure how I'm gonna feel about this, but hopefully it's gonna be nice. There aren't any testers for this, but here's what the applicator looks like. It's a smoothing paddle applicator. Interesting, interesting. They also recently released these powders, which I think is pretty cool, $11.99 each. And apparently there are, what, I think about 12 shades to choose from as well, but these are sold out. We only have these available. Pretty cool. I really love the CoverGirl powder, so I'm curious to see how this one compares to that. Real Techniques recently released this microfiber technology new sponge. It says maximum powder pickup. It's retailing for $5.99, and yeah, it's microfiber. It looks really, really cool. I was not a fan of these sponges from them, but I don't know, I began to try this. It looks really good. I also see that Real Techniques recently released these Life Force brushes. How freaking cool. I love when they release these like brush sets. They're affordable, they're cutesy, they're with it, they're just, I need it. So these are limited edition, and you guys can see that we do have a nice amount of face brushes mainly,
And then I believe there's only one eye brush. Yeah, really cool. The handles are bomb. And most of these brushes are retailing for $12.99 to the most part. Besides for that eye brush, which is $9.99. Finally, I see Cookie and Tickle by Benefit. These are the brand new highlighters they recently released, 30 bucks each. This is my child. I gave birth to this. Yeah, so this one right here is in Cookie. The lighting kind of sucks a little bit, but it's a beautiful champagne-y opal. Yum. And then Tickle looks just like this. It's definitely very pink, but it has a pretty gold undertone to it too. Let's swatch. The bottom one is in Cookie, top one is in Tickle. So Cookie, like I mentioned, is a champagne, and Tickle is like, it's more golden-y than pink, but it has both those colors in there. The texture of these are a bit thick, but I still kind of feel like it's gonna work well on the cheeks. Like I think it's gonna be good. I think it's gonna be good. That's just the texture I felt though. I'm at the Essence section for a moment. I spotted these really cute palettes. They're retailing for $9.99 each. You buy one, you get one half off. Essence is always so affordable. They usually have pretty good makeup items, and they always have deals going on. So the first palette we have up is this Beautiful eyeshadow palette. It's pretty large. Here are what the shades look like. We get 9 different eyeshadows. It's a pretty warm tone palette. I swatched this and I have to tell you guys, damn, I am very intrigued. And I'm so happy that I see it like in store, because I've seen it online, but I was like, ugh, I don't know. But now that I swatched it, I'm like, yes, I'm definitely gonna purchase it online from Ulta. And then here you guys can see how a few of them swatched. Very pigmented, very creamy, no skipping. These are with 2 swipe swatches each. Extremely soft and full on pigmentation. This one right here is called Follow Your Heart. Love the packaging. Here's what this palette looks like. I will say this one swatched a bit more chalkier. I feel like the other one is a bit stronger than this one, but I still love the color story in this palette. And here you guys can see how they swatch. Very, very pretty to the most part though. Then we have the Essence Never Give Up Your Daydream palette. Love the packaging, very cute. And this one I would say was the weakest of them all. Also, I feel like all of these would be highlighting type of shades, not necessarily for the eyes, but you could use it for the eyes as well. There are no mattes in here though. Here's just how a few of these shades swatch. Pretty pigmented but kind of chalky at the same time. I would use this personally as a face highlighter palette. Next up, we have this MAC Love Me lipstick section. So this is just a new lipstick collection they recently released. They have them in 4 different color families, retailing for $19 each. So here are the 4 shades we have. This is part of the purple family. Then we have these lipsticks, which are part of the red family. And then these 3 lipsticks are part of the pink family. I really love the shade Daddy's Girl, because I was Daddy's Girl before my father passed away. And then also because it's a beautiful pink. So starting from the bottom, we have Daddy's Girl. Right above it is Under the Covers. Then we have As If I Care, which I also really like. And then Coffee and Cigs, which is the top one. So pretty. The formula is very, very soft. These are argan oil infused, so they're supposed to be really comfortable on the lips. Then we have the 5 that are part of the red family. The one on bottom is My Little Secret. The one right above it is Shamelessly Vain. Then we have Give Me Fever. Right above that we have 9 Lives, and then Mason Rouge is that cherry shade. Then we have these 2 which are part of like the purpley family. The one on bottom is Laissez Faire. Then one right above it is Hey Frenchie. Then we have Mon Coeur, and then Bated Breath. Some of these names are French. We have some lip balms here from the cream shop. So we have them in various different characters. Really, really cute. And they're retailing for $8 each. Love this baby. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, of course. I hope you enjoyed coming to the city with me, checking out all of the new displays. I would absolutely love to know if there are any new products you guys recently picked up for yourselves, what you think of those products and all of that. Looking forward to hearing your comments down below. And I'll see you guys in hopefully tomorrow's video. fly. Bye.